we love the senior games. The senior games bring so many people together in so many disciplines of art and sports. And we've had so many stories over the years of people that haven't seen each other in years come to the senior games and then reconnect with each other, which is wonderful. But I'm T.J. Everhart Roberts, I'm the Senior Services Director, and we have an amazing staff like Ms. Anna Claire that you probably know that has put together tonight's events, and so we're very excited to get started. But first, in talking about the senior games, I learned something new this week. I learned that putting puzzles together is actually an event of senior games.
Wow.
I did not know that, yeah. So, Theo, where's Theo? Raise your hand, Theo.
Oh,
yes. Theo and Warren were actually at the Lexington Center the other day putting a puzzle together. And I walked in, and as I walked up to them, they were giving each other these high fives, and they were saying 55. And I thought, what are they doing? So I walked a little closer, and as I got closer, they did it again. They gave each other a high five, said 55, and yelled it out. And I thought, well, what are they doing? I said, well, I'm gonna go check this out. So I go up to the table, and they're sitting there with this puzzle, and it's completed. And I said, what are you guys so excited about? What's the high fives all about? And Theo said, Tisha, we put this puzzle together in 55 days.
Oh.
And I said, okay. I said, really? It took you 55 days to put this puzzle together? And Warren speaks up, and he says, well, yeah, Tisha, the box says 2 to 4 years. So anyway, it's very exciting that puzzle putting together, whatever you call it, is a part of senior games now. So, but welcome everyone to the 34th anniversary of our senior games and celebrating the performing arts. The performing arts is actually a philosophy that strives to keep seniors healthy, active, and involved. The performing arts unites the athlete and the artist in a program that recognizes the similarities of both endeavors, and that is discipline, dedication, and pride in one's accomplishments. This evening's showcase of talent will compete in the categories of dance, vocal, comedy, drama, and line dancing. Medals in performing arts are awarded to solo and small groups, which is 2 to 4 performers. One overall winner in the performing arts will represent us in Raleigh in October, and that's the North Carolina Senior Games State Finals. So we'll have one winner tonight that'll go to the big show in Raleigh. Let's see, in the event the winner is unable to perform in Raleigh, then there will be an alternate act that is established to take the winner's place and represent Davidson County at the state finals. So, before we get started, there are some special guests that we would like to recognize. Do we have any of our Senior Services Advisory Board members here? I think Nancy Estep. Nancy is also one of our previous Miss Senior Davidson County, so welcome Nancy and thank you for being here tonight.
Thank you.
We appreciate you joining us to celebrate the talents of these fine performers. And also, most of you know that no event would be possible without our wonderful and dedicated sponsors. So the sponsors for this event, we have Brookstone, and right down here, right hand there. The Local Government Credit Union. We have Humana and Oak Street Health. I saw them. Yeah, back in the corner there. Thank you so much. And also Novant Health. So thank you deeply to our sponsors. We couldn't do all that we do without our wonderful volunteers and our sponsors. So moving right along, your Master of Ceremonies for this evening is Steve Schell. Steve is the current chairman of the Davidson County Board of Commissioners. He and his wife, Linda, have 2 sons and 4 grandchildren. He attended the Davidson County Community College and Forsyth Tech upon graduation from high school, where he then went through a special career training from instructors of the U.S. Department of Justice and the U.S. Secret Service. Steve has completed basic law enforcement training, continuing education as approved by the North Carolina Department of Insurance and the Private Protective Services of North Carolina. He proudly served with the Davidson County Sheriff's Department. He is past president of Shell Driving School Incorporated. He's the current president of A1A Company and East Coast Sureties. That's a tongue tie right there. Steve is a founding father of the North Carolina Mail Agents Association, where he served on the governing board for many years. He has been a licensed private investigator and licensed counterintelligence agent since 1980, but has since retired. Steve represents the Davidson County Board of Commissioners on the following boards and commissions: the Davidson Works Board, Senior Services Advisory Board, the County Sewer Committee, the I-85 Corporate Center Committee, Yakin River Park Committee, the LEPC Board, the New Jail Committee, and the Facilities Committee. He has been a commissioner since 2014 and believes in and loves the people of Davidson County and supports the U.S. Constitution. Steve is proud to be a Christian who believes that all the good things that happen in his life are due to the blessings of Almighty God. To him be the glory. Please welcome the Honorable Steve Schell.
I got hung up in the chair here.
Oh.
Yeah. All that sounded nice, but all the people that have it. More of a bigger public servant. I work for the public. I got to be careful that I don't drop this bottle. You know, when I was 20, if I dropped it, I'd bend over and pick it up. Now you just look at it and say, do I really need this?
Yeah.
Okay. Judging this evening, we have Danielle Kearns. Danielle is a graduate of Appalachian State and is wrapping up her fourth year of teaching theater arts in Davidson County. From elementary school, she has loved performing, whether singing, dancing, playing the viola, or acting. She loves seeing the community that is created through participation in the arts. Her favorite experience thus far was performing in the annual outdoor production of Born in the West End, but well, I bet that was very good. Her favorite part of her career is seeing her students grow into responsible and creative advocates for the arts. Let's welcome Danielle. Our next judge is Becky Bradham. Becky has recently returned to her hometown of Lexington, where she is now on the board of Lexington Live, the theater group she was with during high school and college. She first started acting at Central Davidson, then continued as a BFA major at UNCG for 2 years. She transferred to Chapel Hill, where she received her degree in communications and then became involved with local music and theater support in Savannah, Georgia. Becky has been involved in theater, music, and the arts her entire life, both as a performer and supporter of the arts. This tradition has carried on. Her son, Link, did I pronounce that right? Link Bradley is an accomplished musician who is releasing his first album next month as he transitioned to the U.S. Army Band to finish out his career as an audio engineer. Please welcome Becky Brown. Christy Smith will serve as our auditor this evening. Where you at, Christy? Oh, okay. I used to be able to see that. You used to talk about senior citizens, and now I found that I turned around one day and I was. Christy Smith is the Lexington Senior Center Manager with Davidson County Senior Services. She has been with the agency since September of 2012. Smith holds a BS degree in finance from UNCG and is a 2015 graduate of Ann Johnson Institute of Senior Center Management. She is a 2013 graduate of Leadership Davidson County, and she currently serves on the county's Project Lazarus Coalition, Partners in Prevention, formerly known as DC-SPAN, Davidson County Stop Prescription Abuse Now. Smith and her husband Mark of 27 years have two children together. Sydney, age 25, from William. and Caleb, age 22. They reside in the Hastie community in Thomasville and attend Shady Grove United Methodist Church. Let's give a big hand to Chris. Chrissy does a fine job. She appears for us before, I know Tisha is very proud to have her, because she does a wonderful job, and we appreciate you. Timing the acts in this evening's show is Dana Fleming. She will be ensuring that our acts conform to the time allowed for each performance. Dana is the Admissions and Marketing Director at Brookstone Retirement Center in Lexington, North Carolina. She has worked in healthcare for over 20 years. Out of all her experience in the healthcare field, her heart always leads her back to working with seniors. Please give a big round of applause for Dana. Okay, that brings us to the goodies. You know, I never realized how much time we had in our senior community until I was fortunate enough to MC the event we had at the Smith Center, you know, a couple years ago. And it blew me away. It blew me away. So I'm ready to get this thing rolling, and I know you guys are too. Our first act will be a comedy solo by Warren Miller. He will start the show with a comedy act by Warren Miller, and Warren is a retired Methodist pastor. He has worked in the church for over 36 years. He shares some of the light side events that really happened in the church. God does have a sense of laughter. Please welcome Warren Miller as he performs It Really Happened.
Good evening.
Good evening.
It's good to have you here and glad that you're with us today. You know, the church is a real interesting place, and funny things happen in church. Like, I can remember several years ago, a little kid is just crawling under the pews, him and this little girl, and they're just having the grandest time right in the middle of the sermon, and then everything, all of a sudden, Mother gets up, and she walks over there and picks the little kid up. She moves him around, takes him out, you know, as the kid's being dragged across the floor. As he's being dragged across the floor, he says, "Pray for me." And several years ago, when my oldest boy was about 4 years old, he's sitting in church, and the pastor is talking about the Holy Ghost. Now, all of a sudden, I get this tug on my coat, and Jeremy says it to me. He says, "Dad," those big brown eyes just staring at me. He says, "Dad, tell me about this ghost. Is he friendly, or is he a bad ghost?" He had watched Casper the Friendly Ghost. Well, better story than that. Now, this really happened. You got to help me with this. If I look to you and point to you and say, you got to say, "It really happened in church." Can you say that with me?
"It really happened in church."
Okay, so when I do that, you're going to respond. In my first year as a youth pastor, as I then First Baptist King, and I was there for probably about 6 weeks. Then all of a sudden, you know, the pastor's just preaching away, and he gives an invitation like most Baptist churches. You know, there's 640-some verses of "Just As I Am," and as the choir is just continuing, all of a sudden this lady in trench coat comes walking down. As she walks down the pews, in between the pews, and all of a sudden the pastor just closes the service right then and there. Well, I'm sitting there wondering what has going on. Why is the pastor just running down the aisle? Why is the deacons or whoever they were running down, ushering her back out of the service? So then about 2 days later, we're having staff meeting. And staff meetings are always real interesting. And I was rather new there. And so I'm sitting there, and I finally ask the question, "Why did you close the service?" The Spirit was moving. A lady was coming down the aisle, and she was so interested in either joining the church or giving her life to Christ. And the pastor says, "Well, you don't know her." Said, well, "Tell me about her." Says, "Well, when she's on her meds, she's fine. But when she's not, you never know what she's going to do." And one time she came in there, she came down and she talked to me for a while, and then she turns around, she opens up the trench coat, and she's butt naked. So things like that, it really
happens.
Yes, you got it. Another time there was possums in the parsonage. And the possums in the parsonage, I was running one morning, and as I was running, I saw these little beautiful dead possum right there. As I came back, I saw the possums move. So I looked down and there's little baby possums there. Now I'm an animal lover. I'm not gonna let those poor little baby possums. I took those little baby possums, took them back home, and truly there was possums in the parsonage. And it really
happened in church.
Thank you.
My oldest boy now was about 3 years old when we were in church. Where you turn it on? Can y'all hear me now?
No.
Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? All right, then I have to take it off. I'm going to have to hear somebody. I know we're doing this for that. I'm used to him cordless, my oldest. And he was about 3 years old when he was really being rowdy. And I finally leaned over there and I said, if you don't quiet down and behave yourself here, I said, I'm gonna whip your butt. And it just fueled it. It got louder and louder and louder. And finally I picked up, started at the door, and everything got quiet in the church, and Harold, he was screaming, Daddy, please don't beat me. Please don't beat me. Okay. Ken, second act tonight will be a subway drama by Gene Thompson. Next we'll have a drama monologue by Gene Thompson. Gene is retired from the city of Lexington. In her free time, she enjoyed traveling to Texas and spending time with her three grandchildren. This monologue is a testimony and expression of who she is as a person. Please welcome to the stage Gene Thompson as she performs Who Am I?
Who am I? Who I am? But by the grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace, which was bestowed upon me, was not in vain. But I labored more abundantly than they all, yet not I, but the grace of God, which was with me. Who am I? Who I am? Nay, in all these things, I am more than a conqueror in him who loves me. So, I am. I am who God says I am. I am who God says I am. I'm more than a conqueror in him who loves me. I am who God says I am. I'm saved because God says I'm saved. I'm saved because God says I'm saved. I'm more than a conqueror in him who loves me. I am who God says I am. I'm loved because God says I'm loved. I'm loved because God says I'm loved. I'm more than a conqueror in him who loves me. I am who God says I am. I'm blessed because God says I'm blessed. I'm blessed because God says I'm blessed. I'm more than a conqueror in him who loves me. I am who God says I am. Who am I? Who I am? I am a child of God who has overcome, because greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. So once again, I am who God says I am. I am who God says I am. I'm more than a conqueror than him who loves me. I am who God says I am. I'm free because God says I'm free. I'm free because God says I'm free. I'm more than a conqueror and him who loves me. I am who God says I am. I am saved. I am loved. I am blessed. And most of all, I am free. This is who I am.
Okay, our next act, the Velvets, will perform as our line dancing small group. In 2006, the group started line dancing together. They decided to call themselves the Velvets because the songs they were standing to at the time were Black Velvet. The group consists of Sharon Baldwin, George Dubrue, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. And Maria Reed. They joined Senior Games in 2016 and have been showing off their line dancing talent since. The song they will be line dancing to is called Do Us Walk. The dance for this song was made for wishful thinking, and Sharon converted it to Do Us Walk. The dance is dedicated to Judy and Kenny Earhart. Please join me in welcoming the Velvets to the stage. Next act is from a group called Reminisce Gold, will be our next performance. Patty Warren have performed for churches, senior groups, civic and private gatherings. They enjoy music and love to share their gifts with others. Mike Fragler is joining Warren and Patty as their drummer. Mike is a very gifted musician and has been playing the drums since his teens. They play a wide variety of gospel, country, bluegrass, and oldies from the 50s, 60s, and 70s. Please welcome Remnants of Gold to the stage. Participant that say is very active, whether she's working in Thomasville well, serving as manager and a vendor at the Thomasville Farmers Market, or working at the High Point Senior Center. She loves the outdoors, volunteers with Davidson County Master Gardeners, and is active in her church. Debbie loves the music, especially songs from the 50s and 60s. Listen as she sings Que Sera, Sera, which was written at the request of Alfred Hitchcock for Doris Day to sing in the movie The Man Who Knew Too Much. It won the Oscar for Best Song in 1956 and later was used as a theme song for Day's sitcom. Here is Debbie Dawson singing Que Sera, Sera.
Thank you.
Up next, we have Marie Trotter. Marie and her husband will be married 54 years this coming December. They have four children and four grandchildren. Marie loves to sing and dance as much as possible. Marie and her husband are members of the East Church of Lexington and love the Lord with all their heart. Marie is a substitute teacher for Davidson County Schools, and her husband is a teacher at Brown Middle School. So sit back and enjoy Marie as Marie sings Still Wet. Theo, as he sings, you can't help falling in love.
I see. Oh, the King is coming. The trumpet spells the end. I'm sailing wrong. Rainbow robes are now unfolding. Heaven's grace stands all in place. Heaven's choir is now assembled. Start to sing. Amazing grace. Oh, the King is coming. The King is coming. Praise God. He's coming for me. I just heard the trumpet sounding, and now his face I see. Oh, the King is coming. He's coming for me. Oh, the King is coming. Praise God. He's coming for me.
Okay, our next act is a vocal solo. Patty Miller will be up next. Patty has been singing and playing piano since she was a young girl. She has sung in the choral ensembles, community theater, rock and roll groups, and churches. She studies piano and plays by music and by ear, although her favorite is to learn songs by ear and perform her own arrangements, which she will be doing tonight. She currently plays with an oldies group, Reminisco, with her husband on guitar and drummer. The song she is performing tonight is a personal favorite that she first performed in 1970 when her band, The Velvet Fog, won North Carolina State Battle of the Band. Wow. Now listen as Patty performs Let It Be.
Thank you.
person is Warren Miller. Warren has been playing the guitar since 1968.
Wow.
He has performed on both TV and radio. He has worked and sung with gospel groups, choirs, and special music groups. He also teaches guitar to those who have a love of music. Join me in welcoming Warren as he performs the Wabash Cannonball.
Step onto the astral turf, get yourself
raising her four great grandkids. The song she will be dancing to is called Country Lovin' by Mike Sikorsky. This song is special to her because she knew Mike for many years, and he asked her to choreograph this whole 13 song album. Please give a warm welcome to Sharon Baldwin.
Reminisce. Okay, I got 2 seats. I look like that. Okay. Ribbon is gold. In the dance solo, for our second place winner, Maria Reed. Our first place winner, Sharon Baldwin. Comedy drama solo, first place winner is Jean Thompson. Line dancing small groups, first place winner, the Velvets. The alternate for Performing Arts College for 2022 best overall performance, Wabash Cannonball. Performing Arts Folly 2022 Best Overall Performance, Kay Sarah Sarah. Okay, let's give a big round of applause. Thank you. Be safe.